Ministers, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, today we continue an important tradition. We gather here as the United Nations General Assembly opens to show our resolve to see the Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty enter into force. We do this because we are convinced that the CTBT has a crucial role to play in building a safer, more secure, and saner world. It has been a year of noteworthy events in our efforts toward nuclear disarmament and nonproliferation. In February, we marked the treaty's 15th anniversary. I used that occasion to visit the Preparatory Commission in Vienna, which I chaired in 1999 as my country's delegate. I could see how far we had come, but I am determined to cross the finish line. Over the past year, Indonesia, Guatemala ratified the treaty and Niue signed. I'm heartened by these important steps. At the same time, there are still 8 states that must ratify the treaty for it to enter into force. In order to advance the process, I wrote to each of these countries in June. I appeal to them to follow Indonesia's example and accelerate their ratification process. I urged them to consider how adherence to this treaty could enhance security, promote stability, and build confidence throughout the world. There is a direct link between ending nuclear testing and eradicating nuclear weapons. The cessation of nuclear tests will constrain the development of nuclear weapons. Today, I repeat my call to those 8 states to ratify the CTBT. To countries that remain outside of this treaty, I say, you are failing to live up to your responsibility as a member of the international community. Leaders have a standing offer from me to personally visit and answer any concerns or doubts they may have about the CTBT. The vast majority of countries have endorsed the treaty. To them, I say, you have wisely chosen security over threats, peace over belligerence, and the global good over a narrow vision of national interest. You are showing true leadership. The norm against testing is strong. Countries that have made the decision to test nuclear weapons have provoked unified and principled opposition. But a non-binding norm is not enough. History teaches us that moratoria can and will be broken. The CTBT must become universal law. In the meantime, I urge all states to refrain from the use of new nuclear weapon technologies or from any action that would defeat the object and purpose of the CTBT. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, people of conscience,
organizing this important meeting, Indonesia is in no doubt that the CTBT is essential to the total eradication of nuclear weapons. Thus, Indonesia has been a strong supporter of the CTBT and gave it a further vote of confidence by ratifying it as Annex II country on the 6th of December 2011. Indonesia's commitment to the multilateral undertaking to rid the world of all nuclear weapons is total. Its support for an early entry into force of the CTBT is unwavering. Hence, Indonesia welcomes the increasing number of signatories and state parties to the CTBT. 8 more ratifications by Annex II countries and the treaty will come into force. Indonesia therefore calls on the remaining Annex II countries to complete their ratification process. Co-chairs, on this occasion, I wish to highlight some undertakings that Indonesia is committed to carry out. First, we will seek to showcase the relevance of the CTBT. We will seek to demonstrate how it promotes capacity building at the national and at the regional levels. At the regional level, Indonesia will continue to promote concrete collaboration between CTBTO and the ASEAN Secretariat. The aim, co-chairs, is to enable ASEAN member states through the Southeast Asian Nuclear Weapon-Free Zone Treaty to utilize the verification mechanism embedded in the CTBT. Second, activities and steps to follow up our meeting today. Third, Indonesia is integrating the implementation of the CTBT into the proposed national legislation implementation kit on nuclear security, which we initiated at the Nuclear Security Summit in Seoul earlier this year. The aim is to mainstream provisions related to CTBT implementation into national legislation and regulations. In this regard, we are working closely with the CTBTO and the IAEA, which coordinates with the relevant international organization in the preparation of the implementation kit. With the kit, we expect to ensure successful mainstreaming of the CTBT. Co-chair,
became realistic. Suddenly, it was not a naivete. Suddenly, it became part of realpolitik. It became part of a toolbox of security. So 50 years later, with three times more weapons around than it was the case back in 1962, three times more nuclear weapon states, more fissile material which is still to be better safeguarded, still not safe enough, still not secure enough. We are still in a stage where the final push is still not realistic. The final push might be still a naivete. So what I would like to do today is to plead with the leaders the world needs, that they should be able to say this, yeah, that yes, what happened back in 1962, 50 years ago, can happen again. And yes, it can happen here now to us. And yes, we are doing the right thing now. Not when it is too late or too little, but we are bringing the test ban treaty in force now. And this is what we have to pledge jointly today. Thank you so much.
Promote adherence to the Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty. I'd like also to present and to offer my country's full support for the statement to be issued by this meeting. So President, Iraq signed the CTBT treaty in 2008, and it is a pleasure for me to inform you that the Iraqi Council of Representatives, the parliament, has already completed its second and last reading of the treaty, which means that the ratification of this treaty by the Iraqi parliament is imminent. Besides, the Council of Representatives has recently ratified the IAEA additional protocol. These steps and others have already demonstrated our commitment and prove our seriousness in Iraq and meeting all the requirements of disarmament and non-proliferation. Signing the CTBT and ratifying the additional protocol are demonstrations of the Iraqi will to maintain international peace and security based on the principles and purposes of the United Nations Charter. And in response to the provision of the Iraqi Constitution, in its Article 9, which stipulates, I quote, "The government of Iraq shall respect and implement Iraq's international undertaking in respect of non-proliferation and the non-production or use of nuclear, chemical, and biological weapon, and shall prohibit any equipments, materials, technology, and delivery system related to the development, manufacture, production and use of such weapons, end of the quote. That is why Iraq supports all international and regional efforts being made to build a world free of nuclear powers. In this regard, we believe that non-proliferation of nuclear weapons can only take place through the accession of all states to the NPT and the CTBT, and subject all their establishment and programs for the IAEA comprehensive safeguard system. The state's acceptance to implement the IAEA additional protocol and calling for a universally commitment to it will enhance the role of the IAEA in the field of verification despite the voluntary charter of the additional protocol. Such character will prevent states from taking advantage of the nuclear technology for peaceful purposes. Mr. Chairman, the establishment of free zones of nuclear weapons is an important step on the road of disarmament and non-proliferation for achieving peace and international and regional security. For this reason, Iraq is supporting all efforts to make the Middle East a zone free of nuclear weapons. We look forward to having fruitful outcomes that lead to achieve this goal from the United Nations Conference, which is expected to be held in the coming December in Helsinki in this issue. I thank you very much, Mr. Chair.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I've just been honoured to co-chair the meeting of Friends of the Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty, the biennial ministerial meeting, the presence of the UN Secretary General, Mr. Ban Ki-moon, and many foreign ministers underscores the priority which we all attach to bringing into force the CTBT. The moratorium on nuclear testing continues to hold, but we need to make this norm a force in international law. It's an essential part, of course, of achieving the ultimate goal of a world free of nuclear weapons. Australia and all friends of the CTBT will continue to work hard to bring this about. I'm delighted to have my ministerial counterparts who are also friends of the CTBT with me, Minister Gemba of Japan, Mr. Rosenthal of Holland, and I would invite my co-chair, Foreign Minister Gemba, to make his remarks.
CTBT は核開発、あるいはその改良を行うために通常必要とされる核実験を禁止するものであります。まさに軍縮不拡散の根幹だというふうに言ってよいと思います。インドネシアが今年の2月に批准するという前向きな進展がございました。
The CTBT prohibits any nuclear weapon test that is normally required for the development and improvement of nuclear weapons. This is an important treaty which serves as a foundation of the international disarmament and non-proliferation regime. We have seen progress to a certain level, such as the ratification of the treaty by Indonesia, one of the Annex II countries. The imminent challenge before us is to achieve ratification by other member states, with a focus on remaining Annex II countries to achieve an early entry into force of the treaty.
本日の会合、短い会合でしたけども、力強いメッセージを出すことができたと思ってます。私からは、 すぐに取るべき3つの共同行動を提案をしました。1つは核実験は行ってはならないものであるというデファクト規範をさらに強めること。2つ目はこの条約の署名批准を行っていない国に対して地域内で互いにこれを促すイニシアティブを取っていくこと。そして3つ目は世界のどこで核実験が行われても探知できる監視システム、 International Monitoring System の整備を急ぐことであります。以上です。
Although we had a limited amount of time for today's ministerial meeting, I believe we successfully sent out a strong message. To further promote efforts toward the entry into force of the treaty, I made three specific proposals for united action to be swiftly taken. First, to strengthen the emerging de facto international norm against nuclear tests, that is, all states must refrain from conducting nuclear tests. Second, to encourage more regional initiatives to persuade those countries that have not signed or ratified the CTBT to do so as soon as possible. And third, to accelerate the development of the international monitoring system to detect nuclear tests in any place of the world. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Can I invite Foreign Minister Rosenthal of Holland to address you?
Thank you, Bob. CTBT is an essential part of the non-proliferation and disarmament structure. And the Netherlands have always been one of its strongest advocates. We welcome the strong interest in ratification by Iraq, Thailand, and Angola. We strongly support the early entry into force of CTBT. We are waiting for that. This early entry into force would establish a legally binding comprehensive prohibition on nuclear weapon test explosions or any other nuclear explosions. The priority for the Netherlands is to make the world safer against nuclear threats. And let me be very emphatic about it. North Korea and Iran are currently our most severe challenges. Iran must fulfill its IAEA obligations and abide by all Security Council resolutions, and it needs to convince the world of its peaceful intentions. Another important issue for the Netherlands in this whole realm of making the world more safe from nuclear threats is nuclear terrorism. And for that matter, the Netherlands is proud to host the Nuclear Security Summit in 2014 as a follow-up of the Seoul-Korea Nuclear Summit earlier this year. One of the goals we all share is to reach out with our efforts to a wider public and to explain to them too what we are doing. Thank you.
Thank you, Yuri. Ladies and gentlemen, we now have time for a few questions on the subject of the treaty.
Thank you very much. My name is Jun Oika for NHK Japanese Public TV. I have the same question for all three of ministers, and I will ask my foreign minister in Japanese. Then after, I will ask the same question for two of you.
We both understand Japanese perfectly.
Gemba大臣 にお伺いしたいのは、共同ステートメントでですね、北朝鮮のことをいわば毒出ししていますけれども、そこの必要性、意義ということは、どういうメッセージが込められているということなんでしょうか。So I have the same question to two foreign ministers. So according to their joint statement, it emphasized the importance of the moratorium, and it picks up the two nuclear tests conducted by North Korea. And so in this statement, what kind of message is implying to the North Korea and the threat of nuclear tests by North Korea? Thank you.
一言で言えば、特に喫緊性を感じていると、それがまあいわば今日集まったまさに共同閣僚たちの共通認識であるということだというふうに考えています。このことでですね、北朝鮮がさらなる核実験を行わないようになるということが極めて大事だというふうに思います。
To put in a simple way, the reason that we put North Korea on our joint statement is that we share the notion about the urgency of the crisis surrounding North Korea, and that is why we had achieved the shared recognition among the ministers of the relevant countries. And with this, I hope that North Korea would not conduct any further nuclear tests.
Well, let me say quite clearly that I visited the demilitarized zone in March this year, and I saw with my own eyes what is happening over there on the Korean Peninsula. And for that matter, I can be very brief and explicit that North Korea should abide by all the resolutions on the part of the United Nations and should behave the way we ask them to do from the international community's end.
I just want to say for the record that this treaty is a repudiation of any country that conducts nuclear tests in defiance of world opinion, but it's also an invitation for North Korea to accept an international norm that is now subscribed to by the world and slowly making its way into international law. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to welcome.
Feel that in the last year there's been any progress in the United States toward ratification, and also have the changes in Egypt, do you think, does it make it any more likely that they sign on?
I would commend President Obama for his leadership, his commitment on this issue, and urge the United States Congress to see this challenge as the world sees it.